is required of you. You function as a pillar in the marriage. So from today, I want you to go back home and change your mentality about your husband. He's not been doing this, he's not been doing that. Tomorrow I will give you the key to tune in. The godly key in which you will be, the pillarship in you will draw out.
Amen.
And so the woman functions as a pillar in the church. Beloved, do you know that the woman was used to prepare and anoint the body of Jesus Christ for death? It was a woman. The Peters were there. The Johns were there. The Jameses were there. The Matthews were there. The Lukes were there. But God says, no. This is a very strategic time for me. It's a very critical time in my life. It's a time, you know, that I'm fulfilling purpose and assignment. Something brought me to this earth, and I'm coming very close to that crucial time. And somebody needs to prepare my body in order for me to go through what I'm about to go now. And who did God see? The woman. It's always the woman. So when we say the woman is a pillar, I don't want you to go and get a negative message. I'm a pillar. You, when your husband says, "Give me a pillar," is it about when they compete, we'll see the assignment whether you can pass. And so the woman was given the privilege to anoint the body of Jesus for his death. And I submit to you this evening that the woman is also required to prepare that body. What is the church? The church is the building. No way. Is the church this walls with cotton and light all over? No way. The church is you and me. The Bible says you are the temple of the living God.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. So the church is not in its building, the block they use. The church is we. And so if the woman, God used the woman to prepare his church, which is his body. Remember, the body of Christ is the church. Remember, the church is the body of Christ. Because the church is you, the church is me, the church is her, the church is him. So now, if God used the woman to prepare his body, the church, for his burial, to anoint his body for his burial, God requires the woman to also prepare his body for his coming. What does it take to prepare? It takes you caring for the body. It takes you giving whatever you give, because you're already a life giver. When you come into any church, life needs to surface in that church.
Mm-hmm.
It's not time for gossiping.
Yes, sir.
Please don't get behind that. We are moving ahead.
Tell them.
Nobody has time now. Even Facebook, they are saying Facebook. A lot of people now use it to declare the gospel of Jesus. Wake up from your sleeping slumber. This is not the time where pastor preach about me. You come to church, no nothing, no life transformation, no nothing. I am, you know, people just, I'm a member of the word of faith. I'm a member of living faith. I'm a member of redeemed. I'm a member of trend. And then that's all, the signboard. You need to put something, be an input in the church, in the body of Christ. Be an, if you come, mommy, why is our altar like this? We need to beautify the house of God where the body comes to meet. Okay. Can I buy a flower? Can I do this? The chair, who scattered the chair? Some people might even come to the church and see chairs that are.
Yeah, only my wife concerned me.
Abi. You see the way my mommy Funke said, the way they use ministers to do their two. When you eat finish in McDonald's, then you use them. Pastor, but it's not supposed to be so.
At all.
You are in a we are loaded. You see, God placed us in a strategic position to put hold everything together. Praise the Lord. And so the woman, as I conclude, is meant and required to prepare the body of Jesus Christ for his return. Remember, the body of Jesus Christ is the church. And so the woman is meant to nurture the church. She's meant to provide for the church. She's meant to care for the church. That's why I tell people in my church, you don't find a man beating drum. You the guy for piano, you don't see them. Let a woman take over. Let a woman go and learn and take over. Why does he beat them? This man does not beat drum. Who have anybody to beat? Let a woman take over. Go to piano school. Let it come. You will see whether you're looking for husband. 10 men we on the line. I say, mama mia, what a courage. This girl, young girl, is beating drum and playing piano and singing and playing the guitar. What a courage. Not everything, we wait for the man. Come and carry me to supermarket. Come and carry me to to shopping. Come and carry me to here. Come and carry me to there. A pillar takes up her arm. Oh, that you see, you go to shopping, come do, get her out. I know somebody in my church. 600 years. No, you marry. You are in this country 20 years. You can't learn to drive. So every day for prayer meeting, I didn't come because my husband that day was tired. He said he couldn't bring me. You are not a pillar.
At all.
If you need the man, remember you sometimes. His mind is gone. If you go back through history, you will discover that the last thing that God made was a woman. God's first gift to man is the woman. That was the last thing he gave. God's first gift to the man is the woman. In this lady, you are complete.
Yes, sir.
In this lady, you want to build house, she will help you find a way. You want to go in the house, she will help you find a way. You want to grow whatever business, this woman's idea will help you. By the time you say, I need money for that business, and the woman say, honey, just give me.
Duffy.
Begin to thank God in your closet. When a woman tells you, a godly woman tells you, darling, just 2 months. Let's watch what God will do. She will use every resource in her to make sure she brings it to pass.
That's an article.
And I pray today as you go home with this mentality that you have a worth, that you have value with God. Go home with this mentality that you're not just that kitchen woman. Go home with this mentality that you're not just that prostitute that stands on the way. Go home with this mentality that you're not just that factory worker. Go home with this mentality that you're not just that woman that is always abused and victimized. Go home with this mentality that I'm carrying power in me. I'm carrying power to push out. I'm carrying power to give birth. I'm carrying power to push out there. Because you're carrying the womb. Every woman has the womb. What is the function of the womb? The function of the womb is to give birth.
Yeah, people want to.
If you have seen the woman go too late,
so it's not even
and then talk. With all her last strength, she's pushing. Labor.
Time, no way.
What is the time
problem?
Is not. When
you
touch me,
that was my
first time. What is the danger? My husband is here. Who will help me to tell me, guide me, and tell me some certain secret things? I had to use the last strength I had to push it. Just like a woman can give birth naturally, she can give birth spiritually. A woman can bat out fishing. A woman can bat out good marriage. A woman can bat out good business. A woman can bat out good church. A woman is highly loaded. Let's rise up to our feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's begin to thank God this evening. This is the first part of the woman as a pillar. That as you go home today, I made that mistake. I'm not a preacher that comes to give you sweet story. That I have it all together. You can't find that in me. That's why many places God has opened up for me. They keep calling me back. Because I'm not that one that will come and tell you, oh, holy, holy, I don't know this. No. When I got married to my husband, I used to be that woman. I used to say, why? Because I'm that kind of person. I like everything to be in the order. Why is this not working? Why? I thought when I saw, I thought that, you know, everything is okay. I was thinking it has not been. You will find it in heaven, not here on earth. You will find that man that has everything together. What you? The bishop you see in the television, the apostles you see, the member you see, everybody you see, there's something that is lacking in their eyes. And God has called you and positioned you in this last days as the woman to be able to bring order to every chaos. Hallelujah. So when you get back home, go back with power. Go back to that your home. Go back to that marriage. Go back to that church and make things happen for Jesus Christ. Let's go ahead and begin to thank God this evening. Let's thank Him. Let's bless Him. Let's worship Him. Let's give Him the praise. Give Him the honor that He counted you.